Researchers from Georgia Tech are developing warm skin for robots. The active thermal sensing combines with traditional force sensing to allow the robot to touch identify wood and aluminum with 96% accuracy. And the acorn worm, one of our closest invertebrate relatives, can regrow every major body part, including its nervous system, internal organs, and its head. And humans may share all of the genes that they use to do this. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. Digital capture of eyeballs is now a whole lot easier. Disney Research Zurich has developed a parametric model that allows quicker, less intrusive reconstruction of eyes. Using a database of pre-captured eyes, a single photo from the internet is all that's needed to create the digital eyes. And the system also includes artistic control over parameters like vein depth and thickness, iris geometry, and pupil dilation. The fitting technique algorithm works so well, it can even recreate digital versions of eyeballs from paintings. So, yeah. Spiderwort grew an ear on an apple. The company is developing an open-source CO2 incubator as well as cellulose biomaterials to grow cells in your house. Basically, scaffolds for growing cells typically come from animal or human tissue, but they're developing cell wall architectures from the plants and fungus kingdoms. The system is in the pre-sale stage right now, and the hope is to allow low-cost and open-source DIY kits for schools, labs, and garages. Scientists at Harvard have invented a cigarette-smoking robot. The machine lights and then essentially inhales and exhales the smoke from up to 10 cigarettes at a time. A tiny chip inside, covered with living cells from human lungs, is then used to analyze the effects. They also have a 3D-printed heart-on-a-chip device, and the plan is to eventually create an entire human-on-a-chip to link 10 organ chips together and study the entire human body. Living organisms have been persuaded to make chemical bonds not found in nature. Researchers at Caltech are breeding molecules with silicon carbon compounds, something only chemists could previously accomplish. Synthetically created organosilicon compounds are currently used in pharmaceuticals, semiconductors, and also computer and TV screens. And this new bonding method called directed evolution is non-toxic, cheaper, more efficient, and easier to modify than chemical synthesis. And this is more about reducing the need for precious metals and making silicon carbon bonds than it is about creating androids. For now. Two paralyzed monkeys can walk again thanks to a brain-spine interface. Neuroengineers at Brown University recorded the electrical signals from the movement-controlling area of the monkey's brain, then decoded and sent them to implanted electrodes on the spine. The signal stimulated the spinal cord, and the monkeys not only walked, but reacted naturally to the regained motion. And they're working on improving the hardware with the hope it can someday be used to aid paraplegic humans. SuitX is augmenting the power of human bodies. The flexible exoskeletons are designed to reduce injury and bolster productivity by providing assistance lifting, squatting, and bending. Three models, back X, shoulder X, and leg X, can reduce muscle force up to 50%. They're currently aimed at helping construction and factory workers, but they also have the Phoenix, which is the world's lightest exoskeleton to help those with mobility disorders. A new magnetic ink prints self-healing devices. Microparticles organized by a magnetic field become attracted to one another in the event of a tear, allowing the device to heal itself. The repair can occur with a tear up to 3 millimeters, which is a record in self-healing systems. And the magnetic ink could be used to create self-healing batteries and wearable electrical circuits. Finally, researchers from Northwestern University have developed a wearable skin sensor to measure the composition of your sweat.
I have a skin-like microfluidic device. Please scan for biomarker information.
So it launches an app. It provides that voice recognition that there's a connection here. And then the phone takes a picture of the device. And from analysis of the colors of these different reservoirs that are filled with these color-responsive chemical reagents, we can determine quantitatively the glucose level, the pH, the lactate concentration, the chloride concentration, as well as the total sweat loss during a given period of exercise.
I'm gonna leave it with a non-anthropomorphic walking robot, which means it doesn't walk like this, it walks like... you'll see. And as always, thanks for watching.
operating room, the first light of its kind is installed. No portion of an operation is ever in shadow. Nor is the expectant father forgotten. Here he can get the news officially and suffer under the most comfortable circumstances possible. And for mother, well, she has only to call for her baby, and baby comes sliding through a wall in a draw-like bassinet for a little visit with the new mother. In this $2 million institution, doors are opened by remote control, and on the single floor, patients are easily moved from place to place. Dream grounds for a dream hospital.
For exclusive Vsauce gear and a steady flow of mind-blowing loot, subscribe to the Curiosity Box.